Se vota.
So I gotta, if you don't know what those are, it's to do with video compression. I'll link a Wikipedia article in the description. Now let's move on to something a little bit more difficult for the encoder, Skyrim. I chose the opening scene because it contains lots of basically still shots as well as lots of very quick camera pans. This shows off that NVENC can look good as long as the camera isn't moving too much and as long as there's not too many fast moving objects on screen. As soon as the camera pans quickly though, you see a sudden drop in quality and it's actually quite jarring. Watching this scene in slow motion, you'll see that the player's view gets shaken around a lot and there's lots of extremely fast moving objects on screen. This causes the NVENC encoder to drop in quality massively, while the X2641 stays basically the same. It's these types of scenes that prove to be the biggest challenge for fixed functionality of the grass and the trees. We want the most amount of definition possible so that they don't become a blurry mess. While neither one does particularly, shows that neither encoder is very good when it comes to highly detailed games. The difference is that X264's quality settings can still be pushed farther if you have a more powerful CPU, while NVENC is basically stuck where it is. All is not lost for fixed function encoders though. If you really don't have a powerful enough CPU to do X264 encoding, so I got a video request on my Ryzen versus Intel streaming performance controversy video asking me to show off the real quality.
Ainda com 770. huh?